Yeah, I'm Martin. I'm a trainee passenger guard. Yeah, I mean, basically, on the journey up, we just make sure there's no obstacles in the rack, and if necessary, we have to, you know, stop the train. We try and keep the passengers informed. We point out various landmarks and views on the way up. And today, you know, with the snow and the sunshine, when we got three quarters up, it was beautiful. You know, there's a waterfall shortly after setting off. And then further up, when you get to Rocky Valley, there's beautiful views down to Llanberis Pass. If you're visiting Wales, I would definitely recommend coming and taking a trip up Snowdon on the mountain railway. Very relaxing pace, and there's beautiful views once you get to all the way up and once you get to the summit.
My name is Mustafa. I own this shop. It's called Leonidas in Chester, and it's the best chocolate and coffee shop in Chester, in North West actually. I love my job, I love my shop, I'm very proud of it. It was the reason that I changed direction in my life, really. But yeah, Wales is not too far from here. It's a beautiful part of the world, I love it. It's you know, the scenery, to people. A lot of them locally are farmers, and they are very hands-on, the earthy kind of people, and that's what, for me, probably because of my background really, I respect them a lot more. And scenery-wise, wherever you go, you know, every minute of the day is a different view, even though you're looking at the same direction. It's absolutely stunning, it's beautiful. And people, wherever you go, you can knock anyone's door and they will offer you whatever they have, and you don't get that in many places. But Wales has that closeness, I would say. Really. Love that.
My name is Kenneth Roberts. I just class myself as a clockman, you know. Now this clock is a 30-hour clock. You've got to wind it every 2 days. And it's got a birdcage movement on it, which is a very rare movement. Now this has been brought in for repair. There's a plate there that holds this chain on the rack there. But that's quite a pretty little clock. My favourite castle would be Beaumaris Castle, which is on the island. A very interesting place. They never finished the castle, and I think that would be my favourite. I'm not a fluent Welsh speaker, although my mother is, but it is a difficult language to learn. I can understand it, and I can speak a bit of it, and I know enough to get me by, you know. And the only animals you find here really is the sheep and the horses. And it's a place for sheep, isn't it? There's so many mountains here, isn't it? There's so many hills and rocks, and I don't know, I just like it here.
Castle in England is essentially what they are in all the books and all the movies. There's the moat, there's the upper terrace, and there's the little prison where they kept the prisoners, the secret tunnels. I mean, it's pretty much everything that you can imagine a castle having.
Growing up in this area, obviously I spent a lot of time in Conwy. You've got the castle, you've got all the boats on the quay. If you sit on Conwy Quay and you look across, you can actually see the marina in De Ganwy now as well. Clearly it's a classic castle. It's actually one of the biggest castles probably in North Wales. It's one of those places that, you know, if I tried to describe where this village is, people wouldn't have a clue. But if you turn around and say that you live in a village near Conway, people know more or less where you mean, because most people have heard of Conway because of the castle.